The Philippines' economic performance under the Marcos administration put in the spotlight during Wednesday's economic forum in Qatar. Now, Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual was among the participants, touted Manila's competitiveness in the region. Pascual said the government's flagship infrastructure program, Build, 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 has improved the Philippines' water and power resources, as well as digital connectivity, among others. Aside from public works, Pascual said highlighted government's programs meant to upskill the Filipino workforce. He also vows government will continue and improve policies and programs that will further attract foreign investments and support the country's development. The Philippine government eyes selling its stake at a major expressway in the Central Luzon region. Finance Secretary Ralph Recto told reporters on Thursday the state's ownership of the Subic-Clark-Tarlac Expressway, or SC-TEX, could be sold to governments or government-run pension funds now. He says the SSS and the GSIS will benefit from the move, which he believes will boost the revenues significantly. Recto's remarks came after the Basis Conversion and Development Authority announced its plan to sell its 50% stake in SC-TEX to Metro Pacific Tollways of the MVP Group for at least 20 billion pesos. The SC-TEX is a 94-kilometer expressway that traverses the provinces of Bataan, Pampanga, and Tarlac. Now, under the current agreement, 50% of the revenues go to the Pangilinan-led NLEX Corporation, while the remaining goes to BCDA. Electric vehicles and bicycles may soon become more affordable after the National Economic and Development Authority included them in the list of vehicles that can be brought into the Philippines tariff-free. NEDA announced Thursday tariff rates for EVs will remain at zero until 2028. It also expanded the list of EVs with zero tariffs to include e-motorcycles and e-bikes. NEDA Chief Arsenio Balisacan says the move is expected to boost the country's EV market and encourage more consumers to adopt EVs. Marcos earlier said he wants half of all cars on the Philippines, or in Philippine roads in fact, to be electric by the year 2040. The Philippine Energy Regulator studies the possibility of ordering electric cooperatives and utilities not to disconnect consumers who are unable to pay their electricity bills this month. Alvin El Chico tells us more.
Consumer Cecil Manlanat's Meralco bill in May has arrived, and it is higher than last month's charge. Her problem is the money allotted for her electricity payment won't arrive until the end of the month, which is past the due date of May 23rd.
Bago magkatapusan, mamumutol na sila. Ikatapusan pa namin makukuha yung perang pambayad namin sa bayaran na yan. Huwag na mo nang putulan, di ba? Kung makiusap ka, dapat pagbigyan kasi obligado namang bayaran namin, di naman namin sila tatakbuhan.
But the Energy Regulatory Commission may just save consumers like Cecil from disconnection. ERC Chairperson Mona Lisa Di Malanta says the commission is studying the possibility of ordering distribution utilities and cooperatives to hold off disconnection this month due to the rise in power rates in Luzon and Visayas. Meralco announced a 46 centavo per kilowatt hour increase this month, while some cooperatives in the Visayas implemented more than 3 pesos.
Kung hirap ka in terms of cash flow, gusto mo sana deferred, 'di ba, installment yung payment. Pero kung hindi kasi binigay sa iyo yung deferral, huwag ka naman sanang putulan, 'di ba? Agad-agad. Ang bilis kasi ng mga DUs na mag-enforce ng disconnection.
Meralco will comply if there is an ERC order, but cooperatives ask if the consumers will not pay, how will they handle energy suppliers?
Kung papayagan ang mga co-op na huwag mo nang mamutol or may mandato, sana meron din mandato sa mga power suppliers na ibigay pa rin yung prompt payment discount, tapos magbigay pa rin sila ng time to pay.
Meanwhile, the National Grid confirms consumers will feel the impact of ERC's order allowing a 30% recovery of generating plants in the reserve market.
Translate it into a peso per kilowatt hour. Corresponding to the sa aming mga customers, sa mga DUs, is about more than 10 centavos per kilowatt hour.
The NGCP is also alarmed over the series of thefts of tower parts in the Cebu-Negros-Panay backbone lines.
ginagawang pagnakaos ng mga parte ng kuryente, hindi yan victimless. Sila rin ang mahihirapan dyan. So yung mga community siguro natin na nakapaligid sa mga facilities ng NGCP, tinatawagan namin at nananawagan kaming maging mapagmatiyag.
The system operator says power flow may be affected in the three islands once the pilferage affects the integrity of major transmission lines. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.